lunch break. Cristianknight for another thrilling episode of Lunch Break. Now, if you noticed from this title somewhere up above here somewhere, or below somewhere, we are redoing what we tried to do last week because we lost connection because of the heat or whatever. We are doing Bushwood Paninis. Yes. So we are live right now. And of course, Lunch Break is basically the show that brings you all the many different foods you can make during your break at lunch. So, I'm going to sit you down here. Hopefully I don't press the button. Yeah, good. I didn't press the button. Yeah! Alright, we're doing good. Who's on?
What up, James? How you doing, James? Oh my god, we're on!
Okay. Sorry about that. Got us excited. So, as you see, we are going to be doing Bushwood Paninis. And what are Bushwood Paninis? They're basically a hack to one of the actual sandwiches, or I guess one of the meals that they make at a place called Melt, and it's located in Cleveland, Ohio. You can go to the website and look at all the stuff, blah 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 blah, you know, already giving promotion now. And I forgot to press start live on this three-day episode of Instagram too, right? I'm so bad. Anyway, so what we did is that we hacked one of the sandwiches that they do, which they call it Bushwood Club. I'm making it into panini because I don't have Texas toast to make any actual club. So, yes, we are making Bushwood paninis. And, of course, the only thing that this sandwich entails is that you make, basically, you have the bread, you have the lettuce, got lettuce, tomatoes, oven-roasted turkey, cheese, and bacon, which is in there right now because it takes about 15 minutes to make in the toaster oven. But I found out yesterday, as I was trying to attempt this thrilling episode. What up, Lawrence? You can actually nuke it in the microwave for 2.5 minutes. Just make sure you pay attention to it. What you do is you put a plate, paper plate, put 2 to 3 sheets of paper towels down, put the bacon, do the little cross stitch, which I'm going to show you how to do that in a few minutes. Put another 2 to 3 layers of towel on top of it, nuke the sucker for 2.5 minutes, and then ba-boom, you have bacon for yourself. Watch out. So, let's get this party started. So, as you, like I said before, I'm going to pick you up so you can see it. We put in the bacon to cook inside. It's only got another 5 more minutes before it's done. So, by the time we get to it, we can make 2 sandwiches ready to be devoured. Yes. So, as the first thing we got to do is wash our hands, as always. But before we do that, let's put our real dandy official apron, as we say on any show that we do here. And why is my live not going through for Instagram? It don't like me right now. But if it doesn't do it, it's okay. You can still watch it here on Facebook or on the YouTube when I put it up. All right, so let's put this on and let's get cooking. Let's see. Ooh, I see messages. I should press that button. Hold on. Ah, okay. Because I can't really tell, but you guys already know from the previous episode. So we just continue. Now, let's watch. Okay. And we're back, people. Sorry about that. We had a little bit of a connection issue there. Once again, we lost connection. So we're back. Welcome back to the live. Please come back to the live. Hopefully you can see that we're back on the live. And James Lawrence is back. What up, James Lawrence? How you doing? I know, you guys are the only ones watching right now. But that's good. But we're back. So, and it's a good thing because the bacon is about to be done. Anyway, let's start off on the first thing we need to do, which we're going to be putting a little twist to our actual sandwiches for the Bushwood paninis. And we're making caramelized onions, which you can do on the grill. So, let's turn on the grill. All right, put these on the side. Get our dandy handy cutting board. Get the vegetable knife that we use for it. And get the onion. Like I said, we're making caramelized onions for our sandwiches. So So we're just gonna cut like 2 to 3 reels. And please, people, please practice safety when you're cutting. Don't cut your fingers. Please don't cut your fingers. Or let someone cut this for you. Or even better, you don't have to do this part of the sandwich. I'm just putting in a nice little twist to it. Because it gives it a nice little taste when you cook it all together. Alright, so here we go. And I'm gonna keep these whole because I want them to actually cook
with the flavors
all together. Okay? Then we're gonna take a nice little bowl right here. And we're gonna put, oh look, the bacon's right there. We're gonna put these onions in here. There we go. And the last ones. I'm gonna put this aside for now. Alright. And we're gonna put some Worcestershire sauce. Worcestershire? I don't know, somebody might have to be able to know how to say this. Pondo. At least, like 1 tablespoon of it. Alright. I'm gonna put some onion powder. And some garlic powder. Alright. And then, he's gonna let this mix all together nice and thoroughly. There we go. Because the next thing we're gonna do. Yeah.
Yum, yum, yum.
Next thing we're gonna do, we're gonna put it there. So we need. Grease catcher. I don't know where to go. Oh. The grease catcher for our George grill. All right, so we're gonna put this on here so it can actually cook. Can you hear that already? Oh yeah, it says. Make sure you put these evenly on here on the grill so they can all cook nice and sweet. Right. Close that for now. We're gonna put this aside because we're gonna use it back to put the onions back in there, okay? So let that sit there for about 2 to 3 minutes. There we go, set our timer for about 2 to 3 minutes. So we're gonna put 3 minutes. Now, because those are done, let's take them out.
Put a nice little
pit
over here
while those caramelized onions are cooking. So we're gonna need our dandy handy tongs. Take these out. Alright. There we go. That's one. And that's two. Now as you can see, they became cross-stitched. Mm-hmm. Because I'm going to show you how to do that on here. Okay. We're going to put that to the side for now.
And start doing the
second
part.
Okay. So while those caramelized onions are cooking. Okay. Put that that way. I'm going to show you how to do the bacon. So, we're going to take our... That was a vicious side. We're going to take our meat side. Okay. Meat knife. And get our bacon. So to do this, all you need is basically 3 strips of bacon. There you go. 3 strips of bacon. Cut it in half. There you go. Now we're gonna take our We're gonna take our sheet that we used before. Right. Make sure we take this out. Cause this one's gonna have a whole bunch of grease in it. Right. And use a new one. So you can see how it's done. Right. So now, put this up here. Right. This is the aluminum. Let me just do this so you can catch the grease. It doesn't fall. Let me take it out. Right. And you're going to take three of the strips and lay them out as so. Across. One like that, diagonally. And then the last one, the opposite way. You made your three layers so far. Now, lift one of the sides and take one of the other bacons and put it across. Right? Then lay that one down. Right? So far you're doing good. So now lift up the other two, place another bacon right in the middle, and then set those down. And the last one, just lift up the flap in the middle. And then lay this one down across. Apparently my watches went off for the caramelized onions. And then that's it. And that's how you do the cross stitch. Just like that. Like that. So then now, we're going to stick him in there. Put this to 400. And like the last one. Oh, wait a second. Hold on a second. There's also some grease there. I don't want that grease falling into the bottom. And then set it for 15 minutes. But like I said, you can actually do this in the microwave, okay, and nuke it for 2.5. Literally. So, let's check on our caramelized onions. There we go. Move this forward. Move this guy on the side. And, yeah, okay. And what we're gonna do is we're gonna let a little, we're gonna add a little bit more of the Worcestershire sauce. There we go. Now, we're actually going to, look at that. Oh, you gotta see this. Hold on. Hold on a second. Oh, I left a little bit of the paper. Left a little bit of that. Outer layer of the onion. Look at this. Look at that caramelized onions. Make sure I don't press the button. Okay. So now, let's get our bowl. Put that there. Take our onions off of the grill. Alright. Set that to the side. Now let's clean the grill because we're going to use it to make the paninis, okay? And that dude was trying to follow me. Alright. There we go. Alright. Okay. So let's close the grill for now. Alright, let's prepare the actual sandwiches. Or sandwich? Sandwiches. Sandwiches? Sandwich. One of those two.
Give me one second, be right back. Sure, we're still alive. We are, okay.
I had to check it on the big screen over there. All right, so that's, ooh, what is that? Turn it off for now. Because we should really, actually, bring this in. What we should really do is clean this properly. Okay. So let's see if none of this happens. And it is off, people, just to let you know. Because I know last time some people, got a little bit beside themselves because I was doing or cleaning this while it was still on and plugged in. So don't fear, it's off. I did turn it off. What you guys up to today? What have you eaten? And have you tried any of the recipes from lunch break? I'll definitely love to see what you guys have made, or even if you have any suggestions of what we should make. Sandwich, how it go. Okay, now, so the first thing we're gonna need to do, and I forgot to take it out, is we need a mayonnaise. All right. So, what we're going to do is take a plate, take the breads. Like I said, the Bushwood, club is made with Texas toast. We are using regular bread that's kind of like hamburger bread with seeds on it. Okay, take the mayonnaise and put a nice little spread on one side. There we go. And then put a nice little spread on the other side. I like trying to get the mayonnaise out. And I know there's another one right down there. There we go. Okay. The mayonnaise is on there now. Get my knife. Okay. Spread this nice and even. There we go. There we go. All right. So now both sides have mayonnaise. Put this to the side for now. Okay. The next thing you need to do for this is that the cheese goes on the bottom. Okay. I'm not sure what type of cheese they're using. They're probably using mozzarella cheese. We're gonna put all American white cheese on this to make our sandwich. So this is the layering that you have to do for this. Okay. So you put down the cheese first, right? That's the first thing that goes. Let's just turn this back on. Right? The next thing you're going to put on this is the bacon. So, get the bacon. And just put one of the cross stitches right in there. There we go. Oh, the cross stitch came out. Okay. Put the bacon right there. The next thing you're going to add to this is the actual caramelized onions. So, let's put a little caramelized onions right in there in the middle. There you go. And the next thing you're gonna add to this is the lettuce. So we're gonna take one leaf. Make sure you clean it. Remember, most of these are gonna have dirt in it, so you wanna make sure you clean green leaves or romaine lettuce, because this is romaine lettuce. Very good. Alright, I'm just gonna cut it or fold it in half. There we go. And we can apply it to the sandwich, just like so. Okay. Now the last thing you gotta put on this is the tomato, which we didn't cut yet, but we're about to cut it right now. Get a nice little vegetable knife and slice it through. Can you guys see me from over here? Can you see this? Okay. Yes, I've seen me cut tomatoes before. Just cut it. Normally, make a nice, a few little reels. Loose rain, loose for Steve. So, let's take one, put it right in the middle. Now, the next thing you're gonna do is simple. Close the sandwich. Bam. You're done. Now, like I said, we're making paninis out of these, so let's move this forward. There we go. And take the sandwich, and of course you know what's gonna happen. We're gonna put it on the grill. And there we go. Now, as you can see, it's too big for it, right? So all you gotta do is just squeeze it down slowly until it gets to a certain point right there. And then that's it. Now, once it's on there, you only need to have it on there for 2 to 3 minutes. So we're gonna put it for 2.5. Because everything else that's already inside it has already cooked. There we go. So 2.5 minutes for this, and that one's almost done. It still has another 5 more minutes. And then that's it. You're all done. You basically made yourself, your own self, a Bushwood panini slash hack out of the Bushwood Club that they serve at Melt. Oh yeah. And then now, let's see. Get some plates. So this way we can be prepared to serve this. Let me move this down this way. Oh, smack. You know what I forgot? I forgot something that goes in the damn sandwich. You know what that was? The oven roasted turkey. I just saw it noticed it there. So we might have to take this out right now. Open the layer. There we go. No, it's turkey bacon. I had someone who was telling me that doesn't eat bacon, which I know, I tailored this all to what my sous chef can and can't eat. So, this is oven roasted turkey, and that's turkey bacon, by the way. Because we can't have him eating stuff that he can't have. Okay. And then we'll just put this back on there. Close this back up. As if we didn't do that. There we go. And we're just gonna still reset this. We're not 2.5. So in this way, the turkey, the oven roasted turkey that we just put in there came also cooked along with the panini and stuff. Okay. Alright, so that's doing that. Alright, you're checking on the bacon, and then that's it. So, let's prepare the next one. We have the stuff for it. All you need, like I said, is bread. Okay, is bread. Then you need the mayonnaise. Alright, like I said, this is very simple, you can do at home. If you don't feel like making something big and huge, like I said, you can put the actual bacon in the microwave and nuke it and still have the same results of what we have there. Ooh, what's this? I got a message. Hey, Francia, como está? My Anton, by the way, love. That's in vivo! Okay. There we go. Alright. There. Okay. Now we got the mayonnaise on that side. Ooh, almost dropped that. Spread it. Like so. Onto each layer of the bread. So it can be coated. Do the same thing for the other half. And then you are done with that. Alright. Now, the next thing you're gonna do is, of course, put the cheese there. I'm gonna try to see if I can layer this the way it's supposed to. Put the cheese down. Go. Alright, cheese is down. The bacon goes next, which we did before, so let's get the bacon. Alright, put the bacon across. Alright, now on this, the next thing we're supposed to put is the caramelized onions, right? Which we did before. So we got the cheese, we got the bacon, turkey bacon. Just for those who are listening. We have the caramelized onions, which we're gonna spread a little bit. So this way you can taste it the moment you get into the center. Yeah. Right? Then the oven roasted turkey goes next. And you can use anything you want in this sandwich, actually. You can put chicken, you can put bologna, you can put salami. It depends on you. It depends on your taste. But this is how we're making it for this. I gotta take this out, by the way. This thing is already done. And there you go, people. Look at that. Look at that.
Ready to serve. Right. Put this aside.
Alright. Then the next thing we're gonna put on this is the lettuce or the romaine lettuce. Turn that off. Ooh. Let's get the cheese out. There we go. Alright. The lettuce. And like I said, you only need one leaf for this. Make sure you clean it thoroughly. Get all that dirt out. And then you just fold it in half. Get all that excess water that's on it off. And put it right in the sandwich, just so. Just like that. And the last thing, you're just putting a tomato. Close the bread or the sandwich. Take the sandwich, put it on the grill. You already know what comes next, right? The squish. The squishy. Squish it! That's squish. Alright, and then don't forget to set your time to 2:30. So this way you can take out your sandwich before it becomes burnt. Just say. And then that's basically it. Nothing to that, nothing more to do. All you gotta do is gather the ingredients, which was an onion, tomato, romaine lettuce, which you could also use cabbage if you want to, but it's kind of a little bit hard. So I don't think you might want to do that. Regular lettuce you can probably use. The bacon, of course, which is there. Mayonnaise, and then bread. And that's it. That's all you gotta do. Simple. Literally simple. Nothing more, nothing less. Okay? And once you finish, because that one's actually about to be done. Yeah, maybe right there cooking. And that's it. Like I said before, you can take the bacon and nuke it in the microwave for 2.5 minutes, and you can get the same results you would do on an actual toaster oven, which takes about 15 minutes. So think about it that way. You got to put it on 450 degrees, and then cook it for 15 minutes. Nuke it for 2.5 in the microwave. See? That means it's done. But you get the same results. Just keep in mind, the microwave is a lot more, it's a lot hotter than this, so it'll cook faster, but you want to make sure you keep looking at it, because if you smell bacon, and bacon gets burned and literally charcoal, burn your own bacon. I don't know if you like charcoal bacon, so, some people do, but why would you do that? It makes no sense. So, check to make sure we're still alive. I'm getting like a delay over here. Hey Dan, what up Marlene? What up Andrea? Everyone's coming into this now, like late in the game. You just missed the sandwich, but we have one cooking right here right now, which is about to be done in 10 seconds. So you'll get to see another sandwich be done, because that one's about to be finished. So you can see the layering for the actual Bushwood Panini, hacked from a Bushwood club that is served at a restaurant called Melt in Cleveland, Ohio. Thank you, Ann, for that tidbit. Who told me for this one to be made, okay? This one's done, by the way. So let's take this one out. Ooh, I hear pitter-patters of feet. Do we have a visitor? You might have a visitor. And there you go. That's the sandwich, peoples. That's literally the sandwich. Right there. Uh-oh.
I hear something.
It's Noobs! Doobie is here, people.
What up?
Lunch break. The sous chef has arrived.
Train's just tripping out.
I'm putting the onion away, so this way you can have a little bit more space over here to cook the rest of the stuff. There you go. So the bacon is done. So now you're gonna see me do one more sandwich before we come off the air. And the sous chef is actually here, so he gets to see how we did this as well again.
Up. Trains is tripping. If y'all taking the 7 train, don't do it. Do another train.
And today, basically. Don't do it today. Don't do it any other day, probably.
Trains is tripping. The aliens got the trains messed up from left from yesterday. Y'all be back home and put this stuff up.
All right. There's 2 sandwiches ready to go.
2?
Yeah.
What do you mean 2, man?
2 is ready done.
I'm ready.
So you take the bread, you take the bread. Come on, let's see if we can get the last squirts of this out of here. How much do we have? Okay. never do it. I guess you're referring to the 7 tray, never do it, right? So we're gonna put mayonnaise on the side. Trying to get the last bit of mayonnaise in this jar or whatever it's called. There you go. Right. Because you know, I'm not a person that likes to waste food, so. Come on. You get the last bit. Come out. Come out already. It's like a demon inside. Come out of you. There you go. Okay. See, we got the last one. Alright, so. Get a nice dandy little knife that we have here. Spread the mayonnaise across the bread. Mind you, this is just regular standard bread. There's no really anything to it. But you can try out if you want to. Probably using potato bread. Because mind you, when the mayonnaise gets cooked in the grill, I don't know if you ever noticed, when you do any type of foods and you put ketchup or mayo on the bread and you cook it or you put it in the microwave, whatever, the bread actually absorbs this because it's basically oil. Now if you notice, see right there? I don't know if you can see it. See right there? The mayonnaise is already going into the bread. So when it gets heated up, liquid form, it actually becomes part of the bread. So when you're chewing into this, this bread is infused with the mayonnaise. You ever thought of that, huh? Because whoever has ever had potato bread and they put mayonnaise or butter, you know it goes straight to the bread. Think about it. It absorbs it. That's why when we eat bread and we drink alcohol afterwards, the bread actually absorbs the alcohol. Tidbit. Okay? For those out there who like to drink. Okay? So now we got the bread with the mayonnaise. And we need cheese. For the butter cheese. At the bottom, so it can melt much easier, like so, just like that. Okay. Next thing we're gonna do is put our bacon. So, of course, like I said, the bacon is ready there. We need to get our bacon. So, there we go. Mind you, this will have. Look at that. Can you see that from here? Look at the drips. Look at the drips. See all that? All that grease that came out of the bacon? Do you see that? Put it right on top. Right? Put our nice caramelized onions right in the middle. There we go. Right in the middle. Okay. Next thing you're going to do is what? Who knows? Antonio Brown? What? Hmm. I don't understand that reference. Then we're gonna put the it's not even forget oven roasted turkey as the next layer. Who is that, by the way? There we go. Right? Then the next thing to put is the leaf for the romaine. The romaine lettuce. There we go. Wash it with cold water. Remember, wash stuff with cold water. Because you don't want to end up cooking food by mistake with hot water. Alright. Next to the cream right there. Alright, and like we did with the other one, all we gotta do is fold it so we can have it as a half. Place it right on top of the sandwich, and then do the same by placing a tomato right on top. And close your sandwich. You ain't no deal. It's gonna go inside the grill. Yes. So let's open up the grill. Take the sandwich. Place the sandwich in the middle. Take the sandwich. Make sure it doesn't fold. Squish it so it can become a panini. All the way to a certain point. And then set it for 2.5 minutes. I feel like I have a shadow behind me.
You do.
It's the shoe chef.
You still on?
No, the Instagram never wanted to come on, so it's okay. I don't have enough time to do the Photoshop. No problem. There we go. And then that's it. So you set it in there for 2.5 minutes, and once it's done, bam, you're already good to go. So, you missed that I did a tidbit. Much tomato by the way. I did a tidbit on how to do the bacon actually on the microwave. So
really?
You could put the bacon in the microwave. All you need is a.
Show my dad?
Yes. You need a microwave safe plate or bowl. You put 2 to 3 layers of paper towel down so it can absorb the grease once it's cooked. Right? You put down your bacon, which by the way, I have to make sure that I'm informing you that it's turkey bacon.
No, I already know.
Because I kept saying just the word bacon. And I got a sideline note from somebody who remains anonymous.
Right, okay.
Saying, do we don't eat pork? Like, no, I know
not,
that.
Do we
that's
not
why I
no
get.
Pork?
That's why I only do turkey bacon.
Dude, we ain't gonna eat no pork, right.
Good
looking out, undisclosed name person. But Antonio already knows that.
So, you can put the bacon in there, right? Once you have the paper towel down on the plate.
How long did the bacon go in the microwave?
2.5 minutes.
And it's all the way cooked?
Yes. So then you put also 2 to 3 layers of paper towel on top. So this way it doesn't like spark all over.
5 on the bottom, 2 on top.
No, the same, like 2 to 3 on the bottom. Okay. So then you put it in for 2.5 minutes, boom, and it's nuked. Just keep in mind, the longer you keep in there, the more crisp it becomes. But do watch out that making bacon in the microwave does charcoal it. Because it's hotter more than a toaster oven. Okay?
I would think you have danger of not making it done all the way.
No, it cooks. I already tried it yesterday. Okay. I was so hungry, I made myself the same sandwich that we're eating here today.
After you take the bacon out, then you put it back on the reformer grill?
Well, we put it as part of the sandwich.
No, that's what I mean.
Yeah. Okay. So, so those are ready to go. What do we have? We have a few messages. Oh, wait. This is Anna Zett.
As opposed to Alton. Oh, and from Cole.
Killing
models,
man.
What up, is it? I gotta go that way to see who comes on, because, like I said before, I can't see who comes on from the actual device. Oh, that's how we just done now, too. There we go. So now we're gonna take this one out.
James,
as you can see, the sous chef.
What up,
Jay? It's looking at the notices, or messages.
What up, everybody? TV, man.
On the Facebook. There we go. All right, now we got three sandwiches. So, let's see, we have enough time. Okay, so what I'm gonna do.
Tomatoes also go on the sandwich and you put it on there. And
everything
smash
goes in, yeah, okay, everything goes in. So we're gonna do one more example. Too bad I didn't have the bacon already in there. So you can see
you
it.
Don't throw the bacon in the microwave though, right?
No. Okay. Only because if I try to use the microwave, I might get disconnected.
That's right. Okay.
So.
I thought we solved that problem.
Kind of-ish. Oh, Andrea said hi. I was just saying hi to you there. So I'm going to show the bacon how it's done. So we're going to take these tomatoes, put it to the side, so we can use our meat side.
So you're going to put the bacon in the side. So stop this time.
Yeah, we're still gonna do that. Okay, so we're gonna move this way. I'm gonna turn this guy off so he doesn't cut anything by mistake. And then, once I show you how to do this, we're going to go straight to the taste testing, so this way you can see it.
Someone, you got cheese on it too?
Yes, there is.
Okay. Yes.
I just saw the cheese right there.
Oh, yeah.
So let's just lift this up. So this way you can capture the grease. Okay. Look at that grease. Look at that. Look at that.
So it takes all some of the bad stuff off of the bacon.
Mm-hmm.
Even though it's turkey bacon, but still.
Well, yeah, no, I mean, this is still going to be greasy, regardless.
Yeah.
You know, so, I'm going to put this aside.
We're
going
to grab three strips. Okay.
All right, we're going to put it down. Meat knife. We're going to cut it in half.
Okay, let me say that one.
Right.
So even if you put it in the microwave, you also cut it in half?
Well, because we want it to fit on our sandwich. So we're going to use the cross-stitch method that we did before.
All right.
Okay? So we're going to get the number four that we're going to use to put in there. Set it down. Right. We're going to take three strips of the one we cut off. Mm-hmm. Put one that way, one this way, and then put the last one the same way. Right. So the first one, we're going to roll it up. Right. So this way you can do the cross stitch, mm-hmm. right? Put one right there, right? End to end. Okay. Then put that one down, and then lift the other two up, right? Once you do that, you're going to take another strip, put it right across, and okay. put these down. Right. Then the last one, just lift through the middle, and put it right there, right across.
That's a good technique.
And then you've made your cross stitch bacon.
Looks like a sweater.
Yeah, pretty much.
Like when
your
grandma would knit.
Is this
true
too?
Playback grandma, man.
So like I said before, all you gotta do is put it in there for 15 minutes. Oh.
Okay.
Do we hear your patter-patters of more individuals?
It's Mr. Matt.
It's Mr. Matt. Rolling? Yes, we are live at lunch break.
I interrupted you last week.
Well, last week we actually got interrupted fully. Oh. It got cut off because we had no connection.
Oh, man.
Yeah, so... Okay. Now we're actually...
Did you pay your bill?
I hope we did. I can't answer that while we're live.
It smells good.
Boss is watching. Oh, so okay. We've made a hack toward an actual recipe and meal that they have for a place called Melt. The restaurant is called Melt, and they make a sandwich that's called Bushwood Club, which they use Texas toast. So we made a little hack where we use regular bread, and we made a panini out of it.
Panini bread?
Yes. All
right.
So it has turkey bacon, cheese, oven roasted turkey, it has lettuce, tomatoes, and mayonnaise. So, cool. Seeing we already put that there for now, you guys can dig in if you want.
Time out. How long do we...
15 minutes.
15 minutes.
450.
Oh, 450. Okay,
yeah.
Okay.
That's why I'm just chit-chatting.
People
are alive, so
I know, because
we're missing time while the bacon cooks.
No, they
got to
know how much time to put. But you probably said that already.
Yeah, I did.
But they got to know how much time to put.
Because I started the bacon before the vlog.
All right.
So, go ahead.
This is filling.
Okay, well, I'm going to do this, people, because it's already done.
A little bit longer.
Because I know Kamikyo is not going to eat, because Kamikyo never eats. He's always on his little diet over there.
Look at that. Look at that.
I enjoyed my little rice paper
chicken and broccoli. Szechuan chicken with broccoli.
With the rice paper.
Spring rolls. Yeah. Oh, I actually remember.
I thought spring rolls were veggie. No?
Yes, it was done with rice paper.
Right, but the broccoli is...
Well, they do they do many different types of spring rolls.
Okay,
so there's like a vegetarian style, there's a pork style, there's a shrimp style.
So it has to do with the roll, not the... Thing.
Right.
Okay, the spring roll is supposedly flaked here, mm-hmm. The regular roll is kind of deep fried.
So there's different types of wraps, basically.
That's
right. Mm-hmm.
Cool.
So all we right. did one where it actually was made out of low-sodium rice paper.
That's good. Good luck on this. I learned something new today. That's my limit for the day.
That's what we do.
Right, you guys take care.
Thank you, man.
Okay, Matt.
So, sir, we did this last time off the air. Now he's doing it on the air.
You don't really got to ask, but I'll do it anyway. Is it lunch break delicious? Yes, it is.
It's lunch break delicious.
Yes, it is. I mean, you can tell by the way I was eating it, but...
So, what do you taste? Like, from the first bite you had...
The first bite, I taste the mayonnaise. I mean, I taste the bacon.
Mm-hmm.
I taste the cheese. I taste the lettuce. I taste everything. It tastes like kind of like a super duper BLT.
That is true too.
Because BLT on steroids or something.
It's just lettuce, tomatoes, and bacon, basically. Yeah.
So, but it tastes like a BLT that went to the gym.
I'm
James Adubi. I want one. Y'all come get one. You gotta come down and visit us.
Jay said everyone figured out that that's the lunch slash dinner spot.
Right. Everybody gonna be here like 2 minutes.
That'd be funny if they did. I mean, we have enough to make We have enough to make another three because there's one there already. There's two more left, bacon wise. But you know, we can always do one without bacon. Not everybody has to get bacon. Mm-hmm. First come, first serve.
Oh, I got a good question. For my question.
Yes. I don't understand that, but hopefully I do.
Sorry about that, y'all. Can you substitute the bacon?
Yes.
For like a sausage?
So like I did in the, I think towards the middle, maybe, or maybe in the beginning. This sandwich is just a hack of one of the sandwiches that I saw that they do at the restaurant. So basically, any of the stuff that's in it, you can actually substitute. According to your own taste, you can put in salami, you can put in ham, you can put in yellow cheese, you can put in mozzarella. It really all depends on you and yourself, because remember, you're eating this, and you can try different experiments. I mean, there's nothing wrong with that. That's basically what cooking is trying different experiments and see what happens. A BLT that went to the gym. I like that. I'm gonna put that in the description for Bushwood Panini. A BLT that went to the gym. thank you. That was successful, right?
Absolutely.
We can do that successful lunch break. So people,
every episode gets better.
Well, for now, because I still gotta figure stuff out. But hey, it's working. We're up to 21 episodes, people. 21. Holy crap! We should have like some sort of thing for like what, the 30th episode or something like that.
Yeah.
I don't know. We'll see what happens. But for the panini that we did for the Bushwood, it's just basically cheese, mayonnaise, bacon, oven roasted turkey. Turkey bacon, by the way, people. Uh-oh. Oh, did he just find the bomb in the middle? Caramelized onions, people. Caramelized onions, lettuce and tomatoes. I didn't want to mention that I did it, because there's nothing in the bowl left, so this way he didn't see that I did that, nor the layering. But you guys know, because you guys saw the video already since the beginning. But yes, he just bit into the caramelized onions that were in the middle. Gave it a nice little kick. So, like we always do here on Lunch Break, everybody, I know you're waiting for this sandwich to be done, but I'm hungry, like literally hungry. I haven't eaten. So, as we say in every single episode of Lunch Break, don't settle for less and make it Lunch Break deliciousness your best. Goodbye. Lunch Break.
Okay. Patriotism. There's a word thrown around a lot. It inspires passionate debate, and it's worn like a badge of honor, and with good reason. Because it means love and devotion for one's country. Love. For a word designed to unite, it can also be pretty divisive. You see, there's more to patriotism than flag sequin with onesies and rodeos and quadruple cheeseburgers. Patriotism is love for a country, not just pride in it. But what really makes up this country of ours? What is it we love? It's more than just a huge rock full of animals like cougars and eagles, right? It's the people. Do me a favor. Close your eyes for a second. I want to try something out. Picture the average U.S. citizen. Think about it. How old are they? What's their hair like? How much can they bench? You got one? Okay. So chances are, the person you're picturing right now looks a little different to the real average American. There are 319 million U.S. citizens. 51% are female. So first off, the average American is a woman. Cool, huh? Is that what you pictured? 54 million are Latino, 40 million senior citizens. 27 million are disabled, 18 million are Asian. That's more people in the U.S. than play football and baseball combined. 9 million are lesbian, gay, bi, transgender, more than the entire amount of people that live in the state of Virginia. Around 10 million are redhead, 5.1 million play ultimate frisbee, and 3.5 million are Muslim. Triple the number of people currently serving in the United States military. Almost half the country belongs to minority groups. People who are lesbian, African American, and bi, and transgender, and Native American, and proud of it. We know that labels don't devalue us, they help define us, keeping us dialed into our cultures and our beliefs and who we are as Americans. After all, what's more American than freedom to celebrate the things that make us, us? I mean, it's stitched into the stars and stripes of this country, from the Constitution to Gettysburg, to our motto, E Pluribus Unum, from many, one. It's even in our country's name, the United States. This year, patriotism shouldn't just be about pride of country. It should be about love, love beyond age, disability, sexuality, race, religion, and any other labels. Because the second any of us judge people based on those labels, we're not really being patriotic, are we? So let's try this one more time. Close your eyes. Picture the average Joe or Joan or Juan or Jean-Luc. The real people will make America, America. And this year, whenever you feel the urge to don those star-spangled shorts, set off fireworks the size of my biceps to show love for our country, remember that to love America is to love all Americans. Because love has no labels.
It started out like a totally normal day. Okay, move objection deadline to the third line after survey. Oh, honey, for where you are, you always use the verb star. What are you doing down there? Did you finish your breakfast?
Ow.
Whew. Don't hit your brother. I mean, you have to eat something. Here. Okay, 5 minutes to carpool. Where's my coffee?
You okay, Mom?
Oh, I'm fine. Sandwich orders. What do you want?
Almond butter and jelly.
Spaghetti.
Oh, you sure you're okay?
I'm fine, sweetie.
I am so late. Hey, buddy, how you doing? Hey, honey. You okay?
Yeah, I'm fine.
You sure?
Oh, yeah. Here.
Acai. My favorite. See you guys later.
Where are your shoes? Put your shoes back on, please. You know, go help your sister. We're going in 3 minutes. Oh my God, what am I doing? I forgot to cut off the crust. Voila. Shoes on, potty if you need it. Honey, get your sister. Okay, get her. Nobody move. I'm getting a dustpan. Oh.
Mom.
I think you're having a heart attack.
Honey, do I look like the type of person who has a heart attack? I'm just gonna sit down.
Totally fine. Don't forget to wear the high socks with the shin guards.
Forget about the shin guards, Mom.
Come on, Mrs. Underdog is not gonna wait. Sorry to bother you. I think I might be having a little heart attack. Nothing really, just some nausea, tightening of the jaw, dizziness, shortness of breath, muscle pain, achiness, this terrible pressure in my chest. Oh, really? They can be here in how long? 2 minutes. Can you make it 10? I thought I had gas. Turns out, I was having a heart attack. Heart disease is the number one killer of American women. So now I take care of my heart and I tell the women in my life to do the same.
Sounds great, by the way.
That's nice, sweetie, but that's not my heart. That is. Make it your mission to save your life and the lives of the women you love. Find out more from the American Heart Association at goredforwomen.org.
Oh man, what's wrong, little butt?
Oh, I don't know, big booty. I just feel so little and lumpy. I want to be big and bootyful like you.
You are beautiful. You're just different. And being different is an asset. The world is full of all kinds of great butts. For example,
there are big butts, little butts, round butts, and flat butts. Buns of steel and squishy tushes, old buns and baby booties. Some butts are existential, some butts are influential. Bubble butts, chiseled cheeks, and sassy sour freakage. These butts could break the internet with juicy booties dripping wet. They lit AF, the kids may say out of this world in the worst way.
Wow, so all butts are awesome.
Hell no! Have you seen cigarette butts? Look at this bullshit! These little are toxic!
So I guess what we're saying is that all butts are better than cigarette butts.